What's up, family? We're back with another vlog, and we are just here at Hungry Jack's. We brought my victory class here for lunch.
Some of them.
We've only got four of them.
Yeah.
Feeds on you.
Oh man. Okay. Anyways, so we've been a bit slack with the vlogging this week. It's been a busy one, but
more like we've just been busy with catching up with one another. I think that we've really not had time to just like lay in our bed and hang out. And yeah, we've been enjoying just us two.
Chilling in. Just gotta confess, I've got a new addiction.
He's got a new addiction.
Yeah, I've got a new addiction.
And I've got a new addiction. Okay, let's just admit it, honey. We both got a new addiction.
It's pretty bad.
And our addiction is 3, 2, 1, Fortnite.
It's been keeping us up late at night. Sorry, guys.
Oh my goodness. I'm not even joking you. Like, all we want to do is, as soon as he gets home, we hang out together. I've been loving our hangouts though. Yeah. And we've really been like talking, because usually Taru's just so tired from work and I can't like get a word in because he just wants to sleep, or we've got to edit the vlogs, or he's got to go to the gym, or I've got to go netball. So it's just been so like hectic lately, but it's okay, because this week we actually got to relax and we won't do this again to yous.
Yes, family.
Because we love you, family.
We do love you.
And yous are part of everything. So the next time we have a chill out session, y'all will be there.
But I hope you guys loved the last vlog.
I did
a little bit, and Sarah done most of it. Like I said, Sarah done most of it, so she's really been holding it down with the edits. But I've been busy at work, but I will make sure that I get as much work in there as I can to help out Sarah, and to also give a little twist, give my own little twist on the vlogs. But I hope you guys have an awesome day. Are ready to watch the rest of this vlog. I think it's about time to go order my food. Alrighty, family. Good morning. Sunday morning. Ready for church. Ready to see the fams. Ready to get our praise on. Give it all back to God. So, little funny story this morning. Well, first of all, it wasn't kind of funny because me and Cez just could not wake up this morning for devotion. So we missed out. To be honest, I wasn't really feeling too well. My stomach was kind of, I don't know, but still, should have not used that as a excuse. But what I was saying that was funny was this morning I had like a, I don't know what it was, man, but when I was sleeping, I could hear my nana's voice. And for those of you that didn't watch, or they haven't seen the testimony yet, I was raised by my grandma, my grandpa. Well, they're not actually my grandma and grandpa. Like, they're not my mum's mother and father. They're actually my mum's auntie and uncle. So it's my papa's sister. You guys still with me? Not confused? So it's my mum's dad's sister, so she took me in. Yeah, so it was weird, like I could hear a voice saying, "Daddy, get up for church." You know, I used to hear a voice, or well, that's what it was like back in the day, you know. I'd wake up with Nana, go to church, get everything done with, and then we'd go and have some McDonald's, or we'll come home and Papa's made a feast. Papa's never really been a church goer, but you know, I believe that his heart is in the right place and he knows who God is. He just didn't really want to come with me and Nana early hours of the morning, travel into Newtown just to go to church at St. Anne's. So yeah, it was good flashback, and it was nice to hear my Nana's voice. So I'm taking that as a sign to give her a call. Give her a call in Rarotonga. So anyways, today we've got quite a big day. As in the usual, we've got youth practice. And then we've got an event from Eckhard. So Eckhard is a group that have got together and they spread the word under Pastor Homer. He's a Filipino dude. And Robert is a part of that team. So the members in Eckhard are from different churches and they come together and put events like this on tonight, and you'll see. Stay tuned. We love you guys and see you throughout the day.
God is good
all
the time.
God is good
up up Jesus,
down Satan,
down Satan,
up up Jesus.
Amen. Praise God. Did you get so in there? I don't know to the house. Greetings in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior.
Amen.
Raise your hand if you have a good week.
Amen.
John 4 verse 24 says, God is a spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and in truth.
Yeah.
The main word I got was must. We must worship in spirit and in truth. Amen.
Amen.
This time is not a time for us to be spectators, but a time to remind ourselves of God's faithfulness and his goodness. So before we get into worship, I want everyone to stand up and stretch, because I feel like you're going to get a session.
Oh yeah.
Jesus' name, feel free, sing yourselves free. You know the floor over here is open, where tux is, the aisles are open. Be free in Jesus' name, amen.
Because they can be like, yes. They just want to say yes because they just don't want, they want you to just hurry up and finish. I'm gonna tell you about a story of three. I call these boys, they were young boys, I call them fireproof boys. You know why I call them fireproof boys? Because the fire didn't hurt them.
Amen.
Alright, I'm gonna ask you a question that your teacher, Nana Pastor, will ask you. Oh, I know love for Ileonga Amwa Asta. Huh? Yeah, well, you know, finally, if I eat this, you know. Yeah, I go, Makua, why not love for Ileonga Amwa Asta? Yes, now the smiles come out, shalom. And he's going to be the golden statue.
Amen.
So imagine someone is 30 meters high. That's really tall, amen?
Amen.
Now someone's the golden statue. Now I'm going to name this boy Rack.
Hey,
Rack. Shaq.
Hey, Rack.
I'm going to call Lucky Shaq.
Go Shaq.
And I'm going to call this one Go-Go.
Go-Go.
Okay? So these three boys were around 11 to 14 years old. I'll be King Nebuchadnezzar. And King Nebuchadnezzar said, come all you people and bow down to the golden statue. Everyone came and bowed down to the golden statue except these three boys here. These three boys here didn't bow down to the golden statue that the king built. But the king's workers, who were jealous of these three boys because the king had uplifted them to a higher level in the province to look after some things. So these jealous people went back to the king and said, King, may you live forever. You said that the people may all come and bow down to the golden statue, but your three Hebrew boys that you have given authority over the province of Babylon are not bowing down to the statue.
Amen.
So then King Nebuchadnezzar said, bring them here. And they came before the king like this. And the king said to them, why didn't you bow down to the golden statue? King Nebu says, I'm going to give you one more chance. The music is going to sound.
Amen.
And as the music sounds, I want you to bow down to the golden statue. These boys, like I said, they're like 11 to 14 years old. They say, King Nebu, we are not going to bow down to your golden statue.
Amen.
We serve a God that is stronger and greater than your statue.
Amen.
And Nebuchadnezzar was furious. He said, how dare you? He said, if you don't bow down to my statue, I'm going to throw you into a fiery furnace. Now imagine these three boys. King said, if you don't bow down to this golden statue, I'm going to throw you into this big oven. And they said, King Nebuchadnezzar, with so much authority, they said, King Nebuchadnezzar, we are not going to bow down to your golden statue. We serve a God that would save us from the fiery furnace.
Yeah.
Praise God.
But this is one thing that I like what these three boys said. They had so much faith. They said, but if the God that we serve does not save us from the fiery furnace, we will still not bow down to the golden statue.
Yeah.
Can you imagine the amount of faith that these boys had to have? And so the soldiers came and they grabbed their hands and they tied it. They tied it up and they dragged it to the fiery furnace. Now as the Bible says that as the soldiers went to open the door, the fire was so strong that it blew them back and they fell down and died. But the three boys were still standing. How amazing is that? That a fiery furnace that is so strong to kill the soldiers did not touch these three boys.
Praise God.
What a strong faith that these boys had in God. Amen. And as they were in the fiery furnace, just imagine this. Flames going up like this, and King Nebu is over here and he looks into the fiery furnace and then he turns to his soldiers, his workers, and he says, didn't we throw in three boys into that fiery furnace?
Amen.
And Nebu looks again and he says, I see four people inside the fiery furnace. And the Bible says that these guys, their chains came off. And they started walking around inside the fiery furnace. Walk around inside the fiery furnace. They were walking around the fiery furnace. And Nebuchadnezzar was saying, did I see a fourth person? There's a fourth person inside the fiery furnace. And that's when King Nebu said that was their God. He said, this person looks like a God. That's when he knew that these three boys, their God was more real than his golden statue.
what's happening, family? So church is well and done. Me and wife are just kicking it here because we're waiting for Mum and Julie, Lance, Donne, and Christine, because we're going to go and see her cousin's husband. Has been in hospital for the last 3 days.
Since Tuesday.
So
I think he's like, I don't want to say because I really don't know what's going on with him, but he has been sleeping since Tuesday and he hasn't woken up yet, but we're gonna go see him and see if my cousin's all good.
Yeah, so we're gonna go do that and then we're gonna come back, kick it with the youth for a bit, and then go to that event I was telling you about this morning where Brother Patsy is going to be preaching the word, and it's going to be fire. Service today was really good today. It was just amazing. So, yeah, see
really
you guys.
Here we go. So I wanted to elaborate on our service today a little bit more. So Brother Patsy Robert, I just shared the story about King
Nebuchadnezzar.
And I'm gonna have to take this phone call one moment. Anyways, leading on to what Pastor's message was, which was love, and for the kids to love and obey and respect their parents. And I just loved that message. Like, it was confirmation for me, only because yesterday I took my class out, which was, it was only the four boys. I took my class out for lunch with my husband. And during our car ride, we were just speaking about how we need to respect our parents, how they need to remember where, how hard their parents work for them, and just to love and obey them because they won't always be around. And today, that's exactly what Pastor said, and it was just confirmation for me and my husband because we spoke about it as well. And I was just like crying, and it was beautiful. It was a beautiful service today, like legit. So now I'm going to sing a song for you, my James.
So there you go, guys. Missions for today: respect your parents and give them the love that they deserve. Doesn't matter what they've done in the past, whether they respect you or you didn't understand the smack. It was all
for love. You know, I always get so sad hearing or seeing kids disobey or disrespect their parents. Like, I can't express to you enough, like, it's not the right way to go. There's always another way to go, and humbling yourself and what's that word where you submitting, that's the word, submitting yourself to your parents is the best way to go, because they always have your best interest. They will never do anything that is not in your interest. And if you are one of those kids that don't listen to your parents or are just not respectful, I seriously encourage you to be humble and submit to your parents. They love you so much. And remember that your parents will not always be around.
Yeah.
And just love them. That's the key. Love is the key. And respecting is the key.
Yeah. And doesn't matter how old you are, you're always going to be your parents' baby. So doesn't matter how big you are, how tall you are, how rich you are, always respect your parents because you're still their baby. And you know that cycle doesn't end. Their parents' baby as well. They got to show their respect to their parents as well.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. So we'll see you guys on the road. Thank you, wife, for that little word. Hope you guys took that in. Like I said, see you on the road.
Okay. We love you, family. See you soon. Oh, sorry. One more thing. Shout out to my girl Lua.
Yo.
I'm wearing your bear today.
Yo.
I am wearing your bear. I mean, girl, it doesn't fit me, but all good. I still wore it even though.
Yeah.
It's a bit big on me.
Come on, spin around for the viewers.
Okay.
Okay. I see. Oh, wow.
Get it.
Oh, look at that one.
Oh. My husband doesn't like these, but they're cute.
All right.
Family, we want you to meet someone.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. Danny.
Guys, this is Danny, but his name is like, his nickname is Shui.
Shui? Because do you know what? He's got big feet. Just get him off. So it's always good seeing the bro. We don't see him often, eh?
Where's your wife?
Everyone's upstairs.
I love you. I love you, Danny.
Shout out to my fans. Follow me on. Yeah. Follow me on.
Yo, okay. So we've made it to the hospital. Got mum and dad here. Hello. Got baby Lanston.
Yes.
Sisters. So we're ready to go and see Richie.
Is this fucking man downstairs?
Bro, he doesn't like you, Danny.
We are. So what's up?
Oh! Yeah! Oh,
good boy.
Yeah, they're going now.
The news came to Jesus. Please come fast. Lazarus is sick, and without your help, he will not last. Mary and Martha watched their brother die. They waited for Jesus, he did not come, and they wondered why. The death watch was over, buried 4 days. Somebody said, he'll soon be here, the Lord's on his way. Martha ran to him, and then she cried.
Sorry we didn't get any footage of what we got. Just hanging with them. But the reason why we didn't film much was because it's just really sad. We just want to keep them just intimate family. So we didn't get to get any footage or any of that with my cousin being in hospital. But we have just arrived to
We were shattered because the first event that they had, me and Sarah were stuck in Singapore.
Yeah.
So we're excited to come to the second event.
Yeah, because we did it. And I was so shattered because it was actually on my birthday.
Yeah, super birthday.
Yeah. But because Brother Paddy was actually speaking at the ICAD movement.
Yeah.
So we missed out on that, but we are excited, so come with us.
And as you can hear inside, it's already crazy in there, so let's go.
Now, let's go. This is another thing that we like to do here, is that we like to dance, we like to jump,
yeah.
We like to raise our hands, we like to shout. So what's going to happen is I'm going to invite you guys to come to the front so you guys can praise and worship freely.
Yeah.
Is that cool? It doesn't matter if we didn't have a shower because at the end of the day, y'all would smell the same anyway.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
All right, so guys, with every hands raised in the air right now, church, like this. Heavenly Father, Lord God, Holy Spirit, just move in this place. We are expecting you to do great things. We're expecting you to move mightily in this place. We're expecting for lives to be changed and not be the same. We're expecting that they will break down the chains that are holding them back, and they will move, they will sing, they will jump, they will shout loud and proud that they are a believer, Lord God. And today we will have fun because God wants his children to have fun. So tonight we will shout, we will sing, we will dance because you are the King of Kings, you are the Lord of Lords, you are the Man that is above all names. So tonight, are going to worship like there's no tomorrow. Amen? All this we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. And we all say,
amen.
All right, come to the front, guys. Come on, out of your seats.
Yeah.
You're not allowed to be
here. Come on.
You know, I'm the OG, and that's all I'm gonna say.
Hey,
but in saying that, for today, you know, we got a few things that we want to do. But first off, before we get started, we like to do like icebreakers because we believe that, you know, icebreakers is a good way to break ice. Okay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
So what I'm gonna do, because he doesn't want to be called up, but I'm gonna call him up anyway because I forced him to do so. I'm gonna call CJ to the front.
Let's go, CJ.
Let's go,
CJ.
And CJ is gonna do this little game with you guys.
Let's go,
CJ. And this is the rule: you have to participate. If you don't participate, Jesus is watching.
Amen.
Okay. Now you had that game, the one with the hands. Sit down. Do that thing. Okay. Anyway. Holy Spirit be with him. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Yes, CJ.
Set up. All right. Sit down if you ever went on the train without a ticket, valid ticket.
Sit down.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa. Okay, okay, okay. Now we know who the rebels are without a cause. Okay, we good, we good. All right, guys. We're going to see you guys later.
Whoa, hey.
Right,
what?
Okay, so we have just finished the service and it was such a blessing. Like, blessing.
Oh, guys, you have to see my brother Tuxie shake like he did in the first service. And my sister here, so touched. Her voice is an angel. Girl, no.
So, this is the Echo Band.
Hey, what up?
Say hi to my vlog.
Oh, hello, hello, hello. Girl, take us out.
Say hi to my vlog. Well, fun. Say hi to my vlog. Hi. Say hi to my vlog. Okay, I'm so ready to go.
Hello.
I'm Sarah, what's your name?
Shout out to all your vloggers, all your followers, the best. Follow, subscribe.
Follow me. Okay, this is what I'm excited for.
Alright guys, I will
I'm
serve
excited
you.
For this.
Do you need any help?
Say hi to my vlog.
Hi, vlogger. I'm not the chef.
Yeah,
oh my
right,
gosh,
guys.
That looks so good.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna get some food and then we'll sit down and then we'll eat. Anyways, I wanted you guys to meet Cyrene because Cy is a part of our youth and she's the only Filipino in our youth. Thank God. So Cy was saved last year.
In February.
See, she even knows the day.
Thank God.
Yes.
For his goodness and his grace upon my life.
Yes.
You know?
We're so happy to have Cy a part of our youth. Yeah. Oh, you can look at it. Anyway.
So guys, I just have a little encouragement for you guys. So,
yeah, girl.
You know, don't be afraid to step out of your comfort zone. You know, if you're not safe yourself, that's okay. You know, if you know people and they're encouraging you to go to a youth group, do it. Because I didn't want to go because I was shy and I didn't know what to expect. But God will really use the people around you to help plant a seed in you and to just, you know,
get it, girl. You got this.
To plant that seed in you and to make that step in faith.
Yes.
You know? So God is so good.
And that's what Cy did. So Cy's partner is Lome. Lome.
Oh,
so
Sai, her partner is Yadome, and she only came to visit. Like, she wasn't coming expecting anything. She wasn't expecting to find God. She wasn't expecting.
I was just coming because she was awesome. Yeah.
And she was like, oh yeah, okay, then I'll come meet everyone, meet the family. And then she came and she loved it.
And
so,
every time I came, even though I would get bored and, like, you know, confused what was going on, because I'm not used to this kind of stuff, there was that voice in my head that was like, hey, you know, this is for you. And I'd take it home and I'd think about it, but then I'd brush it off. And then the next time Lomi would invite me, like, that voice would come back again, you know. And little did I know, that was God speaking to me, you yes. know. That was the Holy Spirit speaking to me.
Yes, sister.
I didn't know that I was capable of having the Holy Spirit, but God's so good and He's able to do anything to anybody. Yes. So yes. just do it.
Yes,
know?
Guys. Just see firsthand. This is our baby. Yes, she's our baby in our youth. Because
even though I'm not a baby?
You're not. Girl. She's not a baby, guys. She's pretty old.
I'm 21.
Not that old, but I'm pretty old.
But I'm the baby of the
youth. She's the baby of our youth. So yeah, guys. We love you.
Love you guys. And make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe.
What's up? What's up? What's up?
What's up?
Here it is.
What's up, everyone?
So we're just in the area now. Let me get in the middle. There. So we're just in the area now, back in Brodie, having a little feed before we make our way back home. Aircard was lit, it was good. Brother Patsy delivered the word real well. Unfortunately, we didn't get any footage because it was just too on, man. So yeah, we kicked back after it. We got to taste a bit of Filipino cuisine. Hey, love.
Yeah, it was really good.
Yeah.
I wanted more, but can be selfish.
Yeah. Yeah. So that was on. Got to kick back and fellowship afterwards. How's that going? How's the fellowship?
Oh, good.
Yeah. They're a rowdy bunch.
I know. Tell them how old they thought you were. I was like 30-something.
30-something.
No, I'm only like 19.
So guys, comment down below. Does he really look older than he looks? So he's 19. He's 19, yeah? Wait, stand up, get a good
how
shot.
How old do you think he looks?
Says? Wait, hold on, sorry.
Give them a model, man. Give
them a model. There it is, okay.
No.
Give it.
Get it.
Okay,
get it. Don't flex if you got no muscle.
Oh. See, you guys, comment down below. Does
How old do you think he is?
Does he look his age, 19? Or does he look older?
Guys, because you don't understand. Everywhere we go, if so, it used to be always like me, Taru, Saw, and Kua. Which Saw is Tux's brother. Everyone went, they thought that they were like
our age.
Our age, like dads. They were dads. And sometimes they thought that Saw was Gore's dad. So weird.
So yeah, we're very interested to see what you guys reckon. Yeah, so that's pretty much it for tonight. Also, sorry, we got a DVD from Brother Butty. Shout out to Brother Butty.
Thank you, Patty. We love you so much. Seriously.
Yeah.
I'm so excited to watch this DVD.
He said it's a must watch for married couples, so we're gonna give it a watch. And when we do find out the name of it, when we get to the car, we'll write it down somewhere here. So you guys can have a watch and yeah. So have a good night, see you guys tomorrow.
Guys, I just wanna see what we're eating.
Oh, how rude. Take us for a Wait, sorry.
So we got like 24 nuggets over here. Oh, yeah. We've got a fillet of fish burger with large fries. And my husband always gets the clubhouse burger with fries.
Yeah. And notice, guys, last week there wasn't 25 wicked wings, but
24 nuggets.
And it's all yes or no. Purple rain. Okay, guys. Apple.